2020 is fucked up, said the cleaning lady from my block. And I cannot agree with her more, especially when I know she's working that ass off from dusk to dawn. You said that's how life be, that's pretty sad. That's what she's been doing since she was a younger cat. Her man is retired, she tried to keep her children as cool grown-ups, but they don't see her anymore. Her nightmare will only be over when she'll have the satisfaction of life. That piece of land about 6 square feet and 6 feet deep, which afterlife no one really can escape. I'm asking, is it good to live an existence without any incense, spiritual things for instance? When I'm at the pearly gates, maybe it's all great. Maybe the rewards of afterlife won't be late. The God, the universe and the higher power welcomes you with greeting cards and a bunch of flowers. And does it really matter if you're religious or not? At least you'll be cautious about metapsychosis now. Now raise a hand for the cleaning lady from my block. Yeah, now put it down, cause no one really gives a fuck. If there's no life after death, we're on the wrong path and the situation is sad. It would've been better if you didn't really give a fuck. Like money, bitches turned out for what? I got you where I want you and you probably noticed a few filler lines, a bit of compromise. But with the mumbling rap on the rise, does it even matter that I make dope rhymes? Cause even a hoe that's good at what she does has to like the D, not only the cash. Just because instead of twerking in the clubs out of boredom, she better be looking to get into a college program similar to your hip hop. And how you faking it? And if you don't enjoy this music shit, then why you making it? And if you compromise and don't know what the fuck you're doing, you're like a drunk whore who's stuck outside of the building after a full night of doing it, thinking she's slick, got sick and didn't even make a profit. Now raise a hand, at least a finger, put the drunk whore. Now put it down, cause it's not useful anymore. All of y'all, let me tell you a story back in the day about this rich kid that lived around my way. He wasn't like the rest of us, he party all night, always drinking Cristal, smoking Marlboro Lights. Summer at the beach, winter and ski in between, Greece, Italy, mainly Europe, know what I mean? But besides that, he always thought he was slick. He had all of that without fucking anyone else, shit. But one day, his parents fell victim, horrible accident out, their business was sinking. And all the money was fucking gone, you see, cause it was discovered they got it all illegally made. And guess who fell victim to this terrible fate? In fact, these terrible streets were swallowed the baits. Innocence without the vaccines, with antibiotics, anti-fate, you know what I mean? Now I want everybody to raise a hand for the rich kid from the block. And just put it down, cause no one ever gave a fuck about that kid, man. But for real, the fourth topic I'm gonna be talking about, it's me, gotcha, complex human being, no doubt. I'm making jokes on verse on serious issues like, yo, but if you didn't pay attention, you don't know. And you don't even have the slightest clue about how much I do and how much I think about it too. The life on earth, especially the one under, meaning life after death, but also underground music as a genre. Lyrical text I delivered one after another. First of all, read between the lines, use your mind, because I've been doing this shit for quite some time. Actually, it goes like this. Out of two factual rhymes, I give you 3 subliminals, yo. I don't give a fuck about material matters. Peace to all my weed smoking motherfuckers. Peace to all them bastards who play them suckers, especially the ones who thinking they above us. Peace to all the side chicks who satisfy, some for cash, others for free, like you and I. Peace to all my peoples, the one before me, and the ones who will take over the kingdom. An old saying from a buddy of mine, it's either you got your dick inside or your soul in the sky. And that's why biting someone's style, it's a sin. But if you do it, man, be at peace from within. But in hip hop, you can do it like Mr. Bin. Compromise yourself, always go above the rim. Don't even try to steal a line that's nice from the sublime universal soul slice. Recognize and raise a hand for my man Vexato Vex, the technical MC, the lyrical genius. Raise a hand for my man DJ Slick. Yeah. And another hand for the grace of the band, of which creation we can all enjoy in the end. And if you understood, and if you think that's something you can do, then raise one for yourselves too.